Welcome to Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center 2016 graduation ceremony. It is my pleasure to introduce the graduating class of 2016. I would ask that members of Chorus Seniors step forward carefully. I would ask that everyone please stand for the national anthem, and we do ask that you remove your hats.
Thank you.
Nice. Thank you to my senior chorus members. What a great start to the evening. Good evening, 2016 graduates, Mayor Dana Hilliard, Superintendent Jenny Mosca, Somersworth School Board Chair Don Austin, Ronsford School Board Chair Judith Nelson, members of the Somersworth and Ronsford School Boards, members of the Somersworth City Council and Ronsford Board of Selectmen, parents, families, colleagues, students, and friends. Thank you for joining the administration and staff of Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center in this ceremony celebrating the achievement of earning a high school diploma. These graduates have completely fulfilled their graduation requirements for the state of New Hampshire. More than one of these students here today have overcome incredible obstacles in order to march today. All of these students sitting before you have truly earned the honor of being a graduate of Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center. As is our tradition, we begin every assembly with our expectations. We would ask that you shut off your cell phones or at least put them on vibrate. We ask you to listen attentively and respond appropriately to the speeches. Graduates, I also expect you to keep those potential airborne objects in check during speeches and presentations. Okay. For those of you that are new to the graduation, we have set up a picture lane for photos. The picture lane is to my right, your left. The beginning of the picture lane has the blue balloons. We would ask you to go down the right-hand side. The end is where the right-hand side is. Class officers will receive their diplomas first, and then we will do the first row, second row. A majority of the students are in alphabetical order, so parents, you will need to arrange yourself in medical order, and that would help that move efficiently. We have practiced posing during our practice this morning. One of my fervent beliefs is that we need to be models of the behavior we want to see, and when we make a mistake, we take responsibility for it. The program today, regretfully, has two errors. One, the lower part of the program has the year 2015, and it should be 2016. The second error is one of our graduates was not on there. I will provide correct programs to any parent who would like one. Please contact the school tomorrow and talk with my secretary, Janet Knapp. We will see that it is mailed to you. The missing student is graduating Naomi Brooks Paris. Yes, you're getting your diploma tonight. Class of 2016. Where did the time go? Seems like only yesterday you were at freshman orientation, trying to find where you belonged in a strange new school, finding friends both new and old, and struggling to not only find your locker, but figure out how to open it. Today is the very last time you are a student at Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center. Tomorrow, the doors of Somersworth High School will close behind you, but so many more doors will be opening for you, both now and for the years to come. Tonight is not only your graduation ceremony, but mine as well. This will be my last graduation at Somersworth High School as a staff member. To send you off into the world, I would like to share some of the lessons I've learned over my many years as an educator and an administrator. As some of you have noticed, I bear a certain resemblance to a cartoon character from The Incredibles called Edna Mode. The students of Somersworth High School started calling me Edna back in 2009 when a young man, Danny Rhines, did a drawing of myself as Edna, and Mayor Hilliard, who at the time was assistant principal, was Dr. Death. He was my bodyguard. Okay. The name seems to have stuck over the years. I'm not sure why, as most of her comments are things I would never, ever say. Oh. But when I was in college, I was one of two females majoring in mathematics education. One of my college teachers asked me why I was in his Calculus 3 class and stated, "After all you're going to do is stay home and have babies." He was so wrong. My favorite Edna quote is, "Never look back, darling. It distracts from the now." Your past will always be a part of you, so don't spend so much time dwelling on it that you forget to celebrate the present. I am glad I didn't dwell on my college teacher's comments. Otherwise, I may not have been here today. Your future will be determined by the choices you make. Celebrate your achievements, but accept responsibility for your mistakes. But don't be afraid to make mistakes. A mistake simply means, that didn't work so well. I think I need to do something different. And then try to do something different. And that does not include quitting or calling yourself a failure. It is by continually trying something different that you will discover how you truly learn. This is from a woman who got a D, yes, D, in Algebra 2, her first quarter, and then scored a 610 on her SATs. A grade does not tell you everything. Listen to what your head and heart tell you. Pursue what you love and love what you do. Just make sure it earns enough to keep the lights on in the house. The last 4 years have been adventures with ups and downs, and I would be lying to say life will be smooth from here on out, even though you will not have to take another one of Mr. Robillard's math tests, or listen to Mrs. Vuitton's reiterate, point, evidence, explain it. The world will continue to throw curveballs your way. Your ability to persevere will depend on how you handle the challenges that come to you. A popular post by Ray Davis says it best, a challenge only becomes an obstacle when you bow to it. The world today is a very different place than when I started teaching in Somersworth in 1976. Technology has soared beyond our wildest imagination. Believe it or not, I still have my slide rule. It was the only calculator in the 60s. If you're not sure what it is, ask your parents, or maybe your grandparents. The point is, the world may seem scary at times, but I want you to remember how beautiful it can be. If you see a colorful sunset, take a picture. If you're driving, pull over first. Appreciate the calm of a winter morning after a storm. Look for the good in those around you and find the silver lining in every bad situation. You all have a voice, and I want you to remember using it. Finding your voice can be a struggle, and defending your voice in the face of adversity may be the most challenging thing you ever do. Have courage, for not speaking up may be something you regret for the rest of your life. Be kind to each other. Connect with others over what you have in common and embrace your differences. You will have good days and bad days, and so will everyone else. If someone wrongs you, forgive them and move on. If you've wronged someone, say you're sorry, and more importantly, forgive yourself. Life is special and fragile. Make time to call your parents. Have dinner with your grandparents. Call your friends to wish them a happy birthday, or tell them in person instead of posting it on Facebook. Let the people you know that you love know it. Continue to say please and thank you. And thank you for opening doors, saying hello, wishing me a good day, saying, excuse me, can I help you? How are you doing? Being polite and courteous, humble and kind, costs you nothing and can mean everything to someone else. On behalf of the faculty and staff at Somersworth High School, I wish you the very best in the next part of your journey called life. This school, our faculty, our parents, this community has worked hard to make you incredible Hilltoppers. Carry forward your gift and be incredible for Edna. And remember, as Edna would say, remember, no capes. Just had a feel for my glasses. Okay. It is my honor to introduce the next speaker, the Honorable Mayor Dana Hilliard, the Mayor of City of Somersworth.
Class of 2016. Good job. You remember I used to be your principal. These final moments of your public educational experience is meant for time of celebration and reflection. Life itself is to be celebrated. The greatest gift you will ever receive has already been bestowed upon you. It was crafted out of commitment and love, out of hope and dreams. At this very moment, you are alive. Each breath is to be honored, each inhale and exhale a reminder of the limited time we have been given, and a review of whether it has been appreciated. Appreciate it. There are no guarantees in life. Some of us will achieve our dreams, some will not. Some will live a life of affluence. Some will live comfortable. Some will struggle. Some of us will live a long, healthy life, while others will combat ailments. Others will pass too soon. Each breath to be honored. Each breath to be celebrated. For the time will come when it will be our last. No guarantees. It could come surrounded by loved ones holding our hand, guiding us to the warmth of the light. Or it could come unexpectedly while enjoying drinks, dancing, and listening to music with our friends. Each breath to be honored, each breath to be celebrated. Walk the road of life with purpose wherever you go. Honor differences, honor diversity which binds us. The vast colors of the rainbow of humanity are a reflection of the complexity of the universe and the great spirit who crafted it. Honor those colors by letting them shine. Stop others from extinguishing them. Let your inner rainbow eradicate through the atmosphere and irradiate all of its colors, guiding those others to do the same. Walk the road of life with a sense of being wherever you go. Make a difference. Hold the door for a stranger. Say please. Say thank you. Say good morning. Say I love you. Commit yourself to community. Volunteer. leave your mark by perpetuating the good in others. The battle of humanity is one which is fought each day. You are the soldiers. Fight with kindness. Fight with understanding. These words of wisdom have been echoed to guide us for millennia by those who made a difference. Christ, Buddha, Gandhi, Martin Luther King. Open your heart to making a difference. To create change starts with commitment. To create change starts with you. Wherever You Go, written by Pat Zowill and illustrated by Ezell Wheeler, summarizes the road of life, which will continue and take you on all of your journeys, and how with each mile there are lessons to be learned. My gift to you, class of 2016, is its wisdom. As you know, I've always been a big fan of kids' books. As my former students, you can remember when I read to you periodically. Here is the last time I get to read to you. Wherever you go. When it's time for a journey to learn and grow, roads guide your footsteps wherever you go. Roads give you chances to seek and explore. Want an adventure? Just open a door. Roads go over hills, under bridges, deep in valleys, and high on ridges. If you yearn for the ocean or wish for a stream, roads bring you closer to reaching your dreams. Roads zoom beneath city buildings and tower on high, twinkling like stars in the dark velvet sky, racing past signs reflecting their light, zigging and zagging, turning left, turning right. Roads bend, detours head where you wouldn't expect, showing your various ways to connect, bringing them closer, then curving away. You always have choices to go or to stay. Roads reach across rivers, past harbors and bay, with breathtaking bridges designed to amaze. Attracting two places that once were apart, choosing to cross over, follow your heart. Roads merge, small, distant roads sometimes travel alone, marking the miles out there, all on their own. Then a new road wants to join in the fun, heads the same way, then two become one. Roads grow. Well-traveled roads sometimes need extra space to guide life's adventure to a brand new place. Which path should you choose? That's easy to see. The one you will take where you wish to be. Roads wait for clicking, clattering trains and boats with tall sails, slow-going hay wagons carrying bales, stoplights and crosswalks, a deer with a friend. Roads sometimes pause or just come to an end. Roads climb steep mountains, peaks dusted light with snow, rising above the deep canyons far, far below. Clinging to cliffs, chasing a crowd, reaching the top, try to be proud. Roads remember every life's landmark, the big and the small, the moments you trip, the times you stood tall. Where you are going and where you began, what you expected, what you didn't plan. Roads return. During your journey, you'll ramble, you'll roam, but sooner or later, you'll think of your home. After you've seen all you've needed to see, a road takes you back where you're longing to be. Back to that hill, under that bridge, deep in your valley, high on your ridge. Roads take you all over the planet, but then you'll always can follow them home once again. May the road of life lead you to joy, love, and happiness. May the road of life lead you towards commitment and service to others. May the road of life you celebrate the rainbow of diversity in every breath the universe has granted you. And wherever the road of life may take you, always remember your starting point, the great hilltop city, the city which is your home and your base of support and love. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments. May life's road treat each and every one of you kindly, and may your blood forever run hilltopper blue. Thank you. I now have the honor of introducing our superintendents of schools, Miss Jenny Mosca.
That's all right, I'll give you a couple minutes. You good? All right. Okay, good evening and welcome, parents, families, staff, and friends to our 2016 graduation. First, let me start by thanking our graduates for being the amazing people you have become. Sitting before you this evening may be the next president of the United States, the researcher that completely cures cancer, the mechanic that fixes your car late on a Saturday night. Sitting beside you might be the person who saves you from a toxic relationship, may introduce you to the next love in your life, may become your best friend, or may be the person that sets you up for failure. I state these things to remind us that as these 12 years of education have completed, the door has been opened wide and the world is yours. Make of the opportunity. Some of us need time before we make our next move, while others just dive right into the deep end. Some of us float naturally, while others work hard to keep their head above water. You have been nurtured to care about others, to show empathy and compassion. Educated to demonstrate your knowledge, problem-solving skills, challenged to think critically and deeply. You have learned the value of friends and friendships, as well as the challenge of relationships. You have been engaged citizens within the school community, as well as our community at large. You have learned to communicate effectively, some better than others, while getting your point across. You have learned the value of personal wellness and healthy choices. I ask you to take these skills and help our world become a better place. Value your family and friends. Learn to expand that circle through your experiences and trust of others. As you leave here tonight and start the next chapter of your life, let your voice be heard. Stand up for those who can't on their own. Reflect upon the little things in life that make you smile. Learn to laugh more, worry less, and live in the moment as those moments move with lightning speed. When you say you're sorry, mean it and learn from it. Tell your family that you love them. As stated by Steve Jobs, don't let the noise of other people's opinions drown out your inner voice. Thank you, and I wish you the best. Okay, it's ball time. Get them up quick if you're going to use them. It is my pleasure to introduce the Somersworth High School and Career Tech Center chorus, who will sing Let the River Run, written by Carly Simon under the direction of Julie McTague. So you have a little ball time. Go to it. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Mateg and members of the chorus, for a beautiful performance. It is my honor to welcome the next speaker for the class of 2016, salutatorian Brittany Whitehouse.
Good evening, 2016 graduates, Mayor Dana Hilliard, Superintendent Jenny Mosca, Somersworth School Board Chair John Austin, Rollinsford School Board Chair Judith Nelson, members of the Somersworth and Rollinsford School Boards, members of the Somersworth City Council, members of the Rollinsford Board of Selectmen, Principal Sharon Lampros, parents, family members, staff, students, and friends. Thank you all for coming to celebrate this with us. Years ago, I was not sure if I was going to be standing in this spot and graduating with the people I've been with since my seventh grade year. Due to some political upset between Rollinsford and Somersworth, It was not known if the Rollinsford students would end our high school careers as students of Somersworth High School. Due to the generosity of both school boards, we were allowed to stay and finish out our academic careers, and I think I speak for all Rollinsford students when I say I'm deeply grateful. I walked into school my first day of seventh grade year and immediately thought, what have I gotten myself into? These people are crazy. Everyone already had their group of friends, and it seemed impossible to break into them. But within the first week, I was proven wrong. The first few people I met and talked to were Abby Allen and Haley Baxter, and it spiraled out of control from there. Soon, it no longer felt like the Rollinsford students and the Somersworth students. We're all one group of Somersworth students who just happened to live in different towns. I can remember back to freshman year when no one knew where they were going and everyone struggled with their lockers. Everyone thought Miss G was a little crazy, and we were all afraid to have Miss Blanner due to all the warnings about her biology class. Our backpacks weighed as much as we did because we couldn't get into our lockers, and we were the low people on the totem pole for literally everything we did. It was our first time meeting Miss LaHou, who later became our saving grace. At the end of the year, after our last final, we thought, oh man, three more long years of this. Sophomore year, we thought we had everything figured out and that it would be a fairly easy, laid-back year for us. Then we got into Miss Blanner's biology or honors biology class. We were failing competencies and stressing about projects and tests. We were told by school counselors and teachers to start thinking about college and what we want to major in or other plans for after school, but none of us actually did. Two more long years. Junior year, and we had Miss Doobie or Mr. Lampron for English, and that was a mess for some of us. We had experiences with the Crucible and the Great Gatsby and the memorization of the Gettysburg Address. Prom was an amazing time for all of us to come together as a class and enjoy ourselves while looking absolutely stunning. By the end of the year, we are ready to take over the school and be the top of the food chain, besides the teachers and administration. One more long year. Senior year leads to stress about after high school plans, college applications, scholarship applications, and making memories that will last forever. There have been so many ups and downs throughout the course of our year, but now here we are, sitting before our parents, friends, family, and teachers, getting ready to receive our diplomas and move on in our lives. We will go our separate ways, but we'll return and find our way back to each other, eventually, to relive the past 12 years of our lives. We finally made it, even though it seemed like we wouldn't, and I'm sure I'm not the only one who is excited to move on to the next chapter of my life. I will never forget how you all influenced my life, and I want to thank you for that. Congratulations, class of 2016. I now have the honor to introduce the 2016 valedictorian, Stephanie Lowe.
Thank you, Brittany. Good evening, 2016 graduates, Mayor Daniel Hilliard, Superintendent Jenny Mosca, Somersworth School Board Chair Dawn Austin, Rollinsford School Board Chair Judith Nelson, members of the Somersworth and Rollinsford School Boards, members of the Somersworth City Council, members of the Rollinsford Board of Selectmen, parents, family members, staff, students, and friends. As poet laureate Billy Collins once said, I'm going to speak for 4 minutes. I think you deserve to know that this will be a finite experience. It is well known in the world of public speaking that there is no pleasure you can give an audience that compares to the pleasure they get when it is over. So you can look forward to experiencing that pleasure less than 4 minutes from now. I'm going to try to keep this short, so I'll just skip the whole cliche, we did it part, since we all know why we're here tonight. Instead, I'm just going to talk about the two things I actually want to talk about. First, I would like to thank some important people who have made an impact on both my life as well as many of yours. I'm going to leave the list short because if I thanked everyone, this speech would be like 10 minutes long and nobody needs that. I'd like to thank Ms. Lampros, Ms. Longtime, Mr. Lasher, Mr. Lagarde, Ms. LaHue, Ms. Russo, Seeley, and Durkee. I would love to give a shout out to my Upward Bound people, especially Joshua Gagnon, who was always there for me whenever I had questions, even if it was like 10 o'clock at night. I don't know where I would be without you guys. And I would like to give special thanks to my parents, who have always been there for me and have supported me through all these years, no matter how short-tempered and irritable I got due to lack of sleep and stress. Zanai, hodozenai. Lastly, I want to share some words of wisdom. 2 weeks ago, I was in Atlanta to receive a scholarship, and while I was there, I was given some of the best advice I've ever received. Actually, I wrote most of this speech while I was there. In case you've never been to Atlanta, I can describe it to you in one word: hot. The second I walked out of the airport, I was like, no. I got to meet some really great people while I was there, like really great, like too great. There was this one girl that had taken 13 AP classes in her high school career, and another guy who was also valedictorian of his class, a class of over 300 people who had already finished Calculus 3. Oh yeah, there was also one who had already had already completed his associate's degree before he even finished high school. I was like, wow, these people are amazing. Where do I fit into all of this? I'm just this girl from a small town most people have never even heard of, and I'm here with all these really amazing and intelligent people. And they're just so much better than me. But later, during the gala reception we had to attend, I met one of the sponsors of the scholarships, and after talking for a bit, he decided to give me some advice. He referred to something Steve Jobs had once said and talked about how you limit your own productivity when you think that other people are better than you. Life can be so much broader with one simple fact. Everything around you that you call life was made up by people who were no smarter than you. This advice is something I wanted to share with all of you. We are going to be leaving here, going off into the world, all over the country, and we are going to meet so many new people. People you may think are smarter than you or even better than you. But instead, remember this. You have the ability to change and influence the world we live in, just like they have the ability to. Don't let your perception of yourself hinder your ability to grow and prosper. Congratulations, class of 2016. Good luck. You can do it. It is my pleasure to introduce the Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center Concert Band, who will perform Abracadabra by Frank DeKelly under band director Mr. Matthew Lagarde.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, members of the Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center Band and Mr. Lagarde for a delightful performance. On behalf of the class of 2016, it is my great honor to introduce the faculty member chosen by the graduating class to be the main speaker for their graduation, math teacher and senior class advisor, Mrs. Nancy Lahu.
Good evening, SHS faculty and staff, honored guests, parents, friends, and graduates. I am very honored to be speaking here today. As I reflect on what to say that would be both memorable and meaningful, I realize that I have some pretty big shoes to fill. How can I measure up to speeches by, say, Steve Jobs, who said, "The only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking." Or the words of J.K. Rowling, who told students, "We do not need magic to change the world. We carry all the power we need inside ourselves already." Or, of course, last year's speaker, our very own Matt Carrington, who told SHS graduates to rock the world. So I sought inspiration from one whose views on life are pretty simple. Winnie the Pooh. Think about it. Winnie the Pooh is very goal-oriented. Just look at the lengths to which he will rise to get some honey. I mean, who is silly enough to grab onto a balloon to take them to the top of a tree to reach a beehive buzzing with bees for a little smackerel of honey? Pooh has a pretty clear goal. You have to agree that for a little bear, he is pretty passionate about honey. Along the way, Pooh sometimes finds the pot of honey empty, and yet he does not let that ruin his day. He sees that empty pot of honey as a small setback, but his disappointment always leads to some adventure with his various woodland friends. Sometimes when Pooh does find honey in the jar, he often eats too much, resulting in a rumbly tummy or getting stuck in Rabbit's door. He realizes that he should have perhaps more carefully considered all the pitfalls. Despite all this, Pooh's search for honey is never ending. That's how it goes with goals. Sometimes you face roadblocks or setbacks. Sometimes your achievement is not quite the result for which you were hoping. So I ask you, graduates, what are your passions? What are your goals? Your goals might be immediate, finding summer work, or long-term, like getting through freshman year, surviving boot camp, or succeeding at your first full-time job. Know that there will be obstacles along the way. You may lose your job, dislike your college classes, or be sidetracked by an injury. You may find you want to change your major or career choice, forcing you to follow a different path. What is most important is that you persevere. Like Pooh, you need to remain focused on that pot of honey. Perseverance is what makes Pooh successful. Perseverance will make you successful at whatever you decide to do. I'd like to share with you the story of a couple of people who found success. The first is Nick Woodman. Nick discovered surfing in high school and decided that was all he really wanted to do. He dropped all his other team sports, budgeted his time to maintain a B-plus average in school, and spent every free minute surfing. It wasn't surfing that made him a success, but it was his inspiration. Nick Woodman was an entrepreneur, and still is. His first venture was selling electronic goods on the internet for a small profit. Well, that failed. Then he started another company called Funbug, a gaming and marketing platform that gave users the chance to win cash prizes. He raised $3.9 million from investors. It was a great idea, right? It was 1999. Gaming was taking off. Everyone was connected online. His timing was perfect. Never heard of Funbug? Well, that's because it failed. Within 2 years, Nick's company failed and he lost all the investors' money, the entire $3.9 million. Talk about a setback. So what did he do? He went surfing. And that's where another idea was born, taking videos while he surfed. He began by taping a camera to his hand, but that didn't work. So he spent 18 hours a day, 7 days a week, for 2 years, creating a prototype of a camera that could take videos when wet. He sold those new cameras out of the back of his car. He calls the camera the GoPro. That's right, Nick Woodman's pot of honey is the GoPro. He persevered despite literally losing everything. The second person, the daughter of a personal friend of mine, has a different success story. Maggie started dancing at the age of 2. She decided early on she wanted to be a ballerina. She graduated from high school with years of dance lessons under her belt. Within a few years, Maggie landed a role in the Joffrey Ballet Company in Chicago, one of America's premier dance companies. But that's not the end of the story. About 2 months after joining the company, Maggie landed a jump and broke a bone in her foot, literally ending her career as a ballerina. Her dream was gone in an instant. After 2 years of unsuccessfully trying to heal the foot, Maggie knew she had to give up her dream to dance. She had to find a new path. She enrolled in a 6-month program to become a French pastry chef. She taught herself to decorate wedding cakes and is now the owner and CEO of Maggie Austin Cakes, a company known throughout the world. Her cakes have been admired and enjoyed at parties in Hollywood, Tokyo, Christmas celebrations at the White House, and at the wedding of a Saudi Arabian princess. Her dream changed, but her drive never wavered. I know what you're thinking. I'm not a ballerina, Miss LaHue. I'm not a baker or an inventor, but you could be. You have the choice to be anything you want. The fact is, you have already accomplished so much. So, how many of you have failed a math competency? Nice. Who among you completely missed the idea in an English paper, totally botched a science experiment, or received a low grade on a social studies test that you thought you aced? I know there are many of you who pulled failing grades up to passing, and some of you who thought you might not earn enough credits to be sitting here tonight. Each and every one of you made a choice to find that inner drive, that motivation to work hard and overcome challenges. You already know what perseverance is and how it makes everything possible. Christopher Robin says it best when, after another failed attempt at finding honey, he tells Pooh, "Promise me you will always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think." Your class as a whole knows perseverance in another way. From that first class meeting with only 5 class officers to the last meeting with a room full of students, you were focused on goals. Prom, banquet, project grad, just to name a few. These last 4 years, we've had a lot of fun, but let's admit it's been hard work. We spent way too many hours at Loudoun, where car keys were stolen and students were lost down dirt roads. It took a week to get the orange cornstarch out of our hair and our cars, and we almost froze handing out water at the color run. There were obstacles to overcome, too. Pumpkin fests in the rain, car washes in the blazing sun, and game nights that took way too many hours to set up. One unexpected outcome is seeing how the class came together to cheer for each other during spirit rallies and dance the Greek dance with Miss Lampros at senior banquet. Finding our honeypot, total success. Graduates, you know what it means to persevere. In fact, you all have the tools you need to be successful. Your education and graduation from SHS has opened the door to success. All your teachers, family, and friends support and encourage you to continue to work hard and find that inner drive so that you can successfully find your pot of honey. Your years at SHS taught you that while the path may not be easy, it is perseverance that allows you to forge ahead. Class of 2016, this is your time. Winnie the Pooh reminds you, you can't stay in your corner of the forest waiting for others to come to you. So graduates, don't sit back and let life happen to you. Be an active part of the future you want. Find your passion, persevere through challenges, and see changes in the path as a new and exciting adventure. Maybe that little blue fish Dory says it best, when life gets you down, just keep swimming. And if all else fails, heed the words of Luyan Romack. If you get the chance to sit it out or dance, I hope you dance. I will leave you with the words said best by Winnie the Pooh. How lucky I am to have something that makes saying goodbye so difficult. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Thank you. It is my pleasure to present the president of the class of 2016, someone who I spent countless hours with in the last 4 years, Elizabeth Sweeney.
Thank you, Nancy. Good evening, 2016 graduates. Mayor Dana Hilliard, Superintendent Jenny Mosca, Somersworth School Board Chair Don Austin, Rollinsford School Board Chair Judith Nelson, members of the Somersworth and Rollinsford School Boards, members of the Somersworth City Council, members of the Rollinsford Board of Selectmen, beloved Principal Mrs. Lampros, parents, family members, faculty, students, and friends. Welcome to our graduation. Thank you for joining. This is a celebration of all these kids, these students, these young adults, my peers, completing one of the most daunting and trying tasks of anyone's lifetime, graduating high school. And it's been pretty wild, to say the least. I mean, at first it wasn't totally wild, although we were all wild kids, let me tell you. My first memories were huge swings and underdogs at Little Folks, and everyone's parents coaching everyone's kids in soccer. By the way, my dad still remembers all of you. Elementary school was where we began to form. It's a pity that the question, do you want to be friends, doesn't get you very far in the real world anymore. It's probably given most of us friends to last a lifetime, or at least those next few years. Our population quickly became divided by the wings they placed us in at Maplewood. You were either east or west, and only knew the people in your wing after bonding on the stairs during indoor recess. The book fairs were another great highlight from Maplewood. The ever-present cartoon animal greeting kids outside, and the way the main hall was redone to be a mini Barnes & Noble. Everything about Maplewood and the childhood it gave us became magical, because that was a good childhood, full of wonder. Moving into middle school was extremely bittersweet. I think we were all really thankful we didn't have to hold hands anymore, but no one wanted to do homework or deal with scary teachers. We wanted to grow up in certain ways, but not in others. And that's what made middle school the most awkward and uncomfortable years of anyone's life. Literally, the biggest proof would be at any school dance, where us girls would have our terrible makeup on and our skirts and our shirts that didn't fit our teeny bodies, and all the boys would sit on the benches while the girls would dance in the groups. And when DJ Ryan would put on Bubbly or Nowhere, kids would run around and line up with their boyfriends or girlfriend about 5 inches apart and literally just sway back and forth. All while your best friend kept making faces behind you. Yikes. Guys, if anyone ever makes fun of you for your middle school years, just remember that they were in the exact same boat. Awkward as, well, you know. But middle school didn't end on such the terribly awkward note it began with. Our eighth grade trip really solidified our small community of then 2016ers. The last day of the trip, we all bonded the most. Many of us can probably recall the day, that afternoon, at the 9/11 memorial, when we heard a first responder speak on never getting to say goodbye to loved ones. And then we all proceeded to cry and hug in the middle of the memorial for about a good half hour. At that point, we recognized that these were the familiar faces we had grown up with, and the faces that we would graduate with. It just brought us closer to this moment. And then high school came upon us. Some of us were so ready for it, and some of us were not so ready. It was definitely a lot more freedom, but very quickly, some of us also became ready to leave it. Really, honestly, shout out to the students that have had senioritis since freshman year. I have no idea how you guys survived it, but congratulations. It's been a struggle, and we've been through a lot. Especially this last year, our senior year. I think I speak for just about all of us when I say that this year tried to kill us. It really did. And yet, you are all still sitting here, and I am so incredibly proud of each and every one of you. You persevered. You did all your work, or most of it. You did your best, and that's all that matters. It brought you here. It was good enough. And now we are here, brought to these chairs at such quick acceleration that we don't even know where the time has gone. And no, Ms. Russo, do not ask me to calculate that exact acceleration because I cannot tell you. This is like looking out onto a wide field with expanse rolling hills behind it, right after the sun has set. And the field is dark, but it doesn't feel sinister, whether you're alone or not, and the air isn't so cold that you're shivering. The light from the sun is still sort of visible from beyond the trees and hills, and you can see it reaching back to you, reflected in the pinks and the yellows and the purples that fight for purchase, hanging beneath the clouds, while the stars come out to shoo them away. And you don't feel yourself breathe because it's so pretty, it's such a beautiful moment, and it's so tragic that such immeasurable beauty can't last forever. You feel like everything is perfect. You feel alive and lost and want to bury yourself in the moment forever, just to make it last any moment longer than the fleeting second it exists. That's what this feels like. I mean, it could also be one of those moments where you're looking out onto the ocean or sitting in the middle of the woods, but they all share the same beautiful tragedy of their tiny, fleeting existence and how you felt within it, and how it was incredible and its short lifespan also made it incredible. That's what standing here, graduating high school, feels like. Because even though it felt like the longest sentence of our lives, the last 4 years, our time in high school and with one another is about to come to its end. So I leave you with this, class of 2016. Wherever you go in life, whatever you do, whatever befalls you at points and tries your soul, remember that you have brought yourself this far. You graduated high school and should be proud of yourself. You can do anything because you have come this far and you have earned this diploma. Be the dreamer that you were as a child, because the world is now waiting for you. As our journey, as well as the band journey, has told us multiple times, class of 2016, don't stop believing. Thank you. It is my pleasure now to introduce the senior chorus members singing In My Life by John Lennon and Paul McCartney.
Hello. Well, I just wanted to acknowledge and thank our accompanist, Stephen McKenzie, for playing for us today. And this song will also be accompanied on guitar by Joey Wadamina, graduating senior.
Mr. Hodgson and I have the honor of doing the presentation of scholarships and awards. The recipient of each scholarship and award's name will be read along with the scholarship and the amount that they will be receiving. When the graduate's name is announced, the graduate will rise. We ask that the audience to clap once for each name and that the graduate remain standing until the conclusion of the presentation of all the scholarship and awards. And once all the recipients have been recognized, please congratulate them collectively with a loud applause.
Scholarships are awarded each year by area clubs and organizations. Each group has its own criteria and selection procedure. The following students are the recipients for the class of 2016. Haley Baxter, Franklin Pierce University Alumni Scholarship, $1,000 per year. Kelsey Bickford, the Donald Kowalski Memorial Scholarship, $400. Angel Brady, Mary Riley Memorial Scholarship, $250. Rochester Rotary Scholarship, $500. The Korn Family Memorial Scholarship, $1,500. The Brian Hudson Senior Memorial Scholarship, $750. And the Casey Walters Memorial Scholarship for $2,000. Ariana Cahill Gutierrez. The Empire Beauty School Scholarship, $1,000. Emily Franker. Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship, $2,000. The Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship, $500. And the Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship, $800. Justin Gatcombe. The Robert Bacaris Memorial Scholarship, $500. Michael Godzik. The Women's Club of Somersworth Scholarship, $1,000. Caitlin Grant. The New Hampshire Charitable Foundation Somersworth Success Fund, $2,500. The Somersworth Sons of the American Legion, $500. The Frisbee Memorial Hospital Artist of the Year Scholarship, $500. Shayna Kelly. Liberty Mutual School to Work Scholarship, $1,000. Cynthia Liu. The Brenna Starrett Memorial Scholarship, $500. The Harry Stein Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Stephanie Lowe. The Walter and Pauline Calderwood Foundation Scholarship, $3,000. Richard Royal Eastman Memorial Scholarship, $100.
Alicia Marr. The Timothy Tapscott Memorial Scholarship, $300. Luke Millsbaugh. The Somersworth High School Alumni Scholarship, $1,000. The Richard and Estelle Gagnon Memorial Scholarship, $500. The Norman Valley Memorial Scholarship, $300. The Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship, $2,000. The Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship, $500. The Norman P. Valley Memorial Scholarship, $300. Hunter Mishu. The Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship, $2,000. Dakota Payne. The Kiwanis Club of Dover, $500. The New Hampshire Charitable Foundation Somersworth Success Fund, $2,500. The College Application Day Scholarship, $500. And the Federal Savings Bank Scholarship, $1,000. Janessa Pellman. The Somersworth Association of Educators Scholarship, $650. The Joan Rhodes Memorial Scholarship, $500. Travis Perrin. The Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship, $2,000. The Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship, $500. And the Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship, $500. Bethany Reardon. The Educational Talent Search Scholarship, $800. The Bill Canton Memorial Scholarship, $100. And the Wentworth Douglas Hospital Auxiliary Millennium Scholarship, $100. Mason Randall. Youth to Youth Scholarship, $75. Jamie Sharp. The Somersworth National Honor Society Scholarship, $250. And the Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship, $500. Elizabeth Sweeney. Interact Club Scholarship, $500. The Youth to Youth Scholarship, $75. The Somersworth High School Student Council Scholarship, $250. And the Somersworth National Honor Society Scholarship, $500. Dylan Vayu. The George Nadeau Scholarship, $5,000. The Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship, $500. Hannah Whedon. The Randy Cummings Memorial Culinary Hospitality Scholarship, $1,000. And the Tom Q. Cash Memorial Scholarship, $500. Brittany Whitehouse. The Korn Family Memorial Scholarship, $1,500. The Martha LaFave Memorial Scholarship, $100. The Somersworth High School Student Council Scholarship, $250. The Somersworth National Honor Society Scholarship, $500. And the Annie Wentworth Bear Scholarship, $4,250. You guys can sit down now. The next two awards, we're going to ask the recipient to come up and receive a plaque. The Jacqueline Ferlin Memorial Scholarship. This award is given in memory of Mrs. Ferlin, a Latin teacher of Somersworth High School. This is awarded to a senior who most exemplifies the qualities of warmth, sincerity, sense of humor, enthusiasm, positive attitude, school spirit, and a genuine interest in others. And this award is presented to Emily Franker. The next award is the Dr. Harold Adams Award. This award is given yearly to the student exhibiting the greatest all-around progress during the past school years. The progress is measured through scholastic achievement, service, and character. This award is presented to Cameron Tucker.
At this point in time, we will proceed to do the presentation of the diplomas by Somersworth School Board Chairperson Don Austin and Rollinsford School Board Chairperson Judith Nelson. Now, before we get started, a reminder that we have a picture lane set over right where Mr. Jacobson is. The beginning part of it is the blue, the exit part is the white. I would ask the parents of the class officers to sort of mosey over there right now with Libby Sweeney and Michael Godzik being the lead recipients of the diploma. Once the officers have received their diploma, students are arranged for the most part in alphabetical order and will receive their diplomas in that order. They will be called up by row with the first row following the officers and then next row and next row. Parents, please be safe and respectful as you arrange yourself in alphabetical order based on your teenager's name, and please quickly move on once your teenager has received their diploma and has left the stage. Your cooperation and thoughtfulness is appreciated. Okay, we're looking good. We got some people over there. They got the idea going. Mr. Austin and Ms. Nelson, are you ready? Ms. Sloan and Ms. Lontine, are you ready? Okay. Class marshals, can you prepare the first row? Okay. The first recipient and receiving the first diploma for the graduating class of 2016 is Class President Elizabeth Kelly Sweeney. The longest walk. Take your time. Again, I want to be the only one doing a face plant tonight. Slow down, Libby. Okay.
Receiving the second diploma for the class of 2016 is class historian Michael Andrew Godzik. Marshals, please prepare the front row for the presentation of the diplomas.
Class Vice President, Raven Sky Spinelli. Class Treasurer, Stephanie Lowe. Class Secretary, Angel Marie Brady.
Abigail Teresa Allen. Aiden Eric Anderson. Christopher Ronald April. Lita Victoria Bannon. Troy Ronald Bass. Haley Jean Baxter. Katrina Michelle Bergeron. Olivia Ray Bernier. Kelsey Lynn Bickford. Mercedes Marie Boucher. Cody Austin Bryant. Amanda Faith Busick. Amelia Cabrera. Ariana Natasha Cahill Gutierrez. Savannah Carberry. Jada McKay Carney. Cedric Vongnoy Chanthaboon. Jeffrey Clark. Brandon Howard Colbath. Michaela Marie Conley. Harry Turner Connolly.
Gabriela Cuevas. Alexander Michael Cummings. Derek John Kutry. Sarah Elizabeth Ernst. Naomi May Estes. Emily Sharon Franker. Cole William Gagne. Elizabeth Gail Gallant. Justin Kyle Gatcombe. Mary Goudreau. Hokkaida Itzel German. Logan Scott Giampa. Caitlin Danielle Grant. Justin Tyler Greeno. Josephine Marie Hansen. Joshua Brandon Horaeus. Dylan Irving. Jennifer Lynn Kelly. Shayna Kelly. Tanner Bennett Lavalette. Cynthia Liu. Alicia Marie Claudette Marr. Christopher Anthony Marson Jr. Nicholas Logan Marr. Joshua Hiskia Mawantu. Brittany Lee Hill.
James David McNeil. Matthew Menz. Hunter John Mishu. Cody Todd Mick. Luke William Millspa. Merrick Trevor Mooney. Derek Creighton Morford. Cassidy Lynn Morgan. Alyssa Nicole O'Connor. Brittany Alicia O'Connor. Mai Nguyen Opino. Matthew Orzakowski. Dakota Nelson Payne. Daniel Palacios Mycutt. Naomi Brooke Paris. Ethan Mark Parisi. Unati Jitendrabai Patel. Janessa Lee Pellman. Kelsey Amber Penny. Travis William Perrin. Chantel Monique Randall. Mason Gage Randall. Bethany Renee Reardon. Daniel Lewis Rodriguez. Anthony Patrick Roselli. Griffin Thomas Russell.
Jamie Renee Sharp. Eamon Earl James Smith. James Hogan Smith. Keontae Smith Hurt. Kristen Lynn Stevens Terrio. Bradley Joseph Tibbetts. Michaela Ann Tusingnot. Claudio Tovar Trinidad. Cameron Preston Tucker. Jean-Luc Valdivia. Nicholas Elias Vaughn. Morgan Vega. Dylan Michael Vayu. Joseph William Watamina. Hannah Lynn Whedon. Brittany Morgan Whitehouse. Drew Allen Williams. Parker Seth Williams. Rebecca Catherine Woodall. Alec Young.
Traditionally, the moving of the tassel at graduation is called the turning of the tassel. It symbolizes one's transition from candidate to graduate. Standard protocol in the United States graduation ceremonies dictates that the tassel be worn on the right side of one's mortarboard during commencement, and then after the ceremony, move to the left side. Marshals, please ask the students to stand. Class of 2016, please join me on the count of three to turn your tassel to the left. One, two, three.
Members of the class of 2016, it is my pleasure to officially announce that you are now graduates of Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center.